Hi again. Today we'll continue talking about MVNOs, their advantages compared to regular operators, and we will also discuss why PortaBilling is precisely what you need to launch your MVNO. So, who are MVNOs for? The end users of virtual operators range from migrant communities looking for affordable international calls to travelers needing cost-effective roaming solutions. For example, MVNOs can sign roaming agreements with different operators and, on one hand, offer their customers affordable roaming while traveling around the world, while on the other hand, offer country-specific affordable data plans for those travelers who do not intend to cross borders. MVNOs offer their end users a number of benefits. First and foremost, they provide a more budget-friendly service compared to traditional mobile operators. They optimize products for specific customer segments, and this allows them to optimize their costs as well, and in turn, offer savings to their customers. For example, MVNOs offer more affordable service bundles. And let's take a look at another example. If mobile operators have underutilized capacity, MVNOs can buy cheaper and offer competitive prices to their customers as well. Also, MVNOs have much smaller staff and less components to maintain, which translates into less inertia. This allows them to roll out new products and services faster than traditional MNOs. Some MVNOs differentiate themselves by delivering superior customer service compared to traditional operators, along with user-friendly self-care portals. Launching your MVNO. Now let's consider an example of a service provider MVNO with real-time charging. This means that for every activity, such as customer connecting to browse the internet or making a phone call, a charging request is sent to the MVNO system. The other option without real-time charging means that the mobile operator that hosts the MVNO periodically sends over files containing CDRs for calls, internet sessions, etc. initiated by MVNO customers. These CDRs are imported into PortaBilling or another BSS system on a regular basis. The offline charging bears significant risks of revenue loss because of fraud, so it's not recommended. Once you've secured an agreement with MNO to start providing services as a service provider MVNO, you're going to need a business and operation support system, BOSS, such as PortaBilling, that will allow you to streamline product catalogs, customer data, service provisioning, real-time charging, authorization, and payment collection for the services you provide. In the real-time charging model, PortaBilling interacts with the mobile operator's system via diameter protocol and generates invoices, processes payments, for example, credit card payments via a self-care portal, provisions mobile services, SIM cards, and mobile numbers. PortaBilling's SIM card MSISDN inventory enables MVNOs to easily manage the inventory of available phone numbers, mobile phone numbers, MSISDN, and SIM and eSIM cards that can be provisioned to customers' devices. So, how does PortaBilling interact with MNO's backend? The interaction between MVNOs and MNO's mobile core consists of two channels. The first one is for activating and deactivating SIM cards, and the second one is for processing charging requests. The SIM card activation process typically utilizes a proprietary API of MNO defined by their BSS or internal system. In this regard, PortaBilling offers a significant advantage, as operational processes can be configured by either expanding the PortaBilling API or by creating an integration using PortaOne workflows. In the description below, you will find a link to an interesting case study that highlights how Travel Sim, an Australian MVNO, implemented SIM cards provision and flow to Optus MNO in Australia with PortaBilling. On the other hand, the standard for charging is typically diameter 4G protocol. PortaBilling supports diameter and the 5G standard charging interface directly. In cases where the operator does not provide access to these interfaces, it is relatively straightforward to build such an integration using PortaOne workflows. In the next video, we will talk about the main concepts and practical skills that you are going to learn in this course. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more of our informative videos. Thanks for watching!